Her sphinx voice curls around your dreary snarls and mocks them with goddess-like serenity and power. Through the litter and the dirt, round the jagged little corners of your fibreglass and concrete and your gaudy plastic shop fronts, behind the stench of fates and minds, their limits, spite and hate, can you hear the haunting wail of her unfair perfection, huge and dark and female in the lower sky? Always seeing where you're at, but not inclined to save you. Apt to raise you up, but leave you hanging. Heavy and oppressive, but alluring as a drug. She's Alaia, but she's gone. Just an instant before you see the form of her. She draws you on in anguish that you'll always fall short of her, and yes, you always will. But then again, she might just be lying when she says that, or lying now in saying this. Reach for her, she'll make this very difficult, and some of you she'll break in two, and some she will caress, while seeming to imply there's a reason for these differences, and yet she may be lying by implying so. Reach for her, she'll kiss you. Lick your ear or make you kill yourself. Reach for her. She'll undulate a tentacle of shivers through your flesh or lick your eyeballs. She'll light you up with wine or burn your mouth away with acid, making certain that these outcomes are not in your control. When the sun blasts fire on the globe's other side, you may hear her. Catch her late tonight, behind the siren of the train in the distance when you half wake. The train roars along the blasted viaduct, screaming, and drowns out a screech from an arch underneath it as the siren blares on for a whole long minute, stops a moment, then returns for another blaring minute. And you'll arch through her colonnades and spin your hula hoops along her yellow-twilit viaducts among your sweaty sheets, every one of you. But when at last you see her, then she's gone. Did you ever feel led on? Do you think she lies? Listen hard.